Meron po mga bagay na pag nangyayari po sa buhay natin, sa ating pamilya, ayaw po natin pag-usapan.
Yes.
There are things that when this thing happens to our family, we opt not to talk about such things. And one of the things that we don't want to discuss in our family is about suicide. Everybody heard about suicide. I think 2 years ago, I heard of a boy, a teenager boy, committing a suicide because nag-break up sila ng kanyang GF, ng kanyang girlfriend. Just because his girlfriend told him, I no longer love you. So, committed suicide. What a very sad story. Nangyari po yan dyan sa may Santa Monica. Suicide, ayaw po natin pag-usapan. Pero hindi niyo po ba alam na unconsciously, unknowingly, every day, we commit suicide. Pakilabas po yung first. When we take away the colors and joy of life, we are unconsciously committing suicide. Amen? Why? Kasi po, Jesus Christ said, if you hate your brother, you are already guilty of committing murder. So if we take away our joy and the colors of our life, unknowingly we are already committing suicide. Pag ikaw po ay nagmumukmuk, punong-puno ka ng sama ng loob, hindi mo alam, ikaw po ay nagpukumit na ng suicide. Why? Because that is not the kind of life that Jesus came and wanted to give us. Kaya nga po sa aklat po ng Juan, in the book of John, 10, verse 10, ang sabi po doon, a thief is only there to steal and kill and destroy. Jesus Christ said, I came so they can have real life, eternal life. When we say real life, eternal life, that's full of power. It doesn't mean you will have no trials, struggles, but in spite of every trial and struggle that we face, we can see the colors of our life. And we become joyful, especially when we understand the purpose of every struggle and trials.
Yes.
And Jesus Christ, this is the main reason why Jesus Christ came. And why we accepted Him as our Lord and our Savior. Because we want to have that real life, that eternal life in us. So when we take away this truth in us, we are already committing suicide. When we look at our life, and when you say, my life is bitter, not better, then we are already committing suicide. When we look at our neighbor, our friend, our relative, and we look at them as problem, you are already committing suicide. More and better life than they ever dreamed of.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
What a God we have. What a Savior we have. Ito po yung topic ko ngayon. Ano po? Worry. Killing me softly. One more pinto tayos. One more pinto tayos. Kasi meron po yan na dapat hindi tayo ganyan. Sino po dito yung may mga worries in life? Wow. You are killing your life softly. Amen? If you know that you only have a short time to live, halimbawa, you're already senior citizen, and you can feel you will not last long, I will suggest read and reread Matthew 5-7. And if you are just starting with God, read and reread Matthew 5, chapter 5-7. Why? For so many years, I thought that when Jesus Christ gave this message, I thought that he was addressing the crowd. But as I re-studied it again, I found that it was not actually for the unbelievers, but for the believers. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 1 and 2, ang sabi po doon, and seeing the multitudes went up, and seeing the multitudes, Jesus Christ went up to a mountain. And when he was seated, his disciples came to him. Can you see the picture? Tumingin po ang Panginoon super sa maraming tao, ginawa niya, umakyat siya, naupo, at yung kanyang mga disipulo, lumapit sa kanya. Verse 2, then he opened his mouth and taught them. Who was with them? The disciples. So he opened his mouth and taught his disciples, not the crowd. Saying, he started to give what we call now the beatitude, the beautiful attitude. So it was not addressed to the crowd. It was addressed to his inner circle, the disciples. Ano bang siku sa English? Siku Heights. Come on, you just tell your neighbor. This message is for us. Not for the crowd. If you have Jesus in you, this is for you. Because not all people have Jesus in their life. Amen? It's true that God is God to everybody, but God is not a father to everybody. He's only a father to a few who believe and trust and gave their lives to Him. And we are so blessed to belong to such a group that we can call God as our Father and that we can hear directly from the mouth of Jesus teaching us principles of life. Amen? So I want you to just listen. Of course, you have nothing to do with it. Listen. And then while you are listening there, sitting down, listening to the message of God, use your mind, use your brain. Anong gagawin ko sa mensahe? What will I do to the message of God? Because all of the message of God, I believe, we already know the message of God. But the big question is, we are not applying the messages of God, especially the principles of living that God taught us about. And this is just one thing. Worrying is just one thing. Di po ba? Everybody knows, alam po, lalak po tayo, alam natin, we know, na sinabi ng Panginoon, don't worry, but we still keep on worrying. Amen?
Yes.
Di po sinasabi ko, alam natin, pero hindi natin ginagawa. Matthew 6, verse 25, no? After so many teachings, again, Jesus Christ came to this one particular principle. Sabi niya, therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life. What you will eat, or what you will drink, not about your body, what you will put on. Of course, it doesn't mean you have to come here next Sunday without anything in your body. Not unless you will live in Garden of Eden. What you will put on, is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? sinasabi ng ating Panginoon sa first day? Ano po pinapakita ng Diyos? 27, which of you by worrying can add one cubit or one second or one inch to your height or one second to your life? Meron na bang nagawa pag iniisip mo, ikaw ay 4'11 na, gusto mo maging 5 feet, nag-worry ka na, nag-worry. Tumangkad ka ba nung ikaw nag-worry? Yeah. O kaya tumuputi na yung buhok mo, no? You're starting to see your hair turning to gray, and you worry so much, and you worry that, sana umitin ulit. Sa kapunayan, the more you worry, the more that you will get gray hair. Of course, except to sa mga Western na ating mga kapatid ngayon. Bagay kasi sa kanila yung gray hair. Kasi yung kanilang balat puti. Sa atin mukha hindi bagay, ano? Black and white kasi nangyayari. Pero ito po, hindi ko ba totoo? May nangyari na ba sa buhay mo nung ikaw ay nag-worry? Wala. Anong nangyari? Mayroon nangyari. Anong nangyari? Nawalan ka ng kaligayahan, naging bitter ka sa buhay mo, nawalan ka ng kapayapaan, yung buong mundo, the whole world already smiling while you keep on frowning. Because you worry so much. Ano po yung talagita ng Panginoon sa Kristo in those three verses? Pinakita po ni Jesus that if sinabi po ng ating Panginoon, don't worry even for the basics of life. Food is basic. Yes. Right? Yes. And when Adam and Eve, when God created Adam and Eve, He did not tell them to wear clothes because the world is still, the climate of the world was still pure. Pero ngayon po, the climate of the world is, it's already polluted, that's why we have to wear clothes so that we will not get sick. So, yung pinaka-basic po, when God created heaven and earth and humanity in it, the very basic is just food.
Yes.
Clothing is primary, secondary. Now, if God tells us to not even worry for the basic of life, to most millennials, to young people, there are already tertiary. Food, clothing, gadget. Gadget has now become part of your life. Diba? That you feel you lack something if you don't have those things. Right? Kaya nga, you nakikiano kayo sa inyong mga magulang, magmamakaawa kayo na magulahan. Kasi nga, it has already been part. Para bang pakiramdam nyo, basic na ngayon ang magkaroon ng cellphone. Kasi pag wala kang cellphone, ikaw ay OP, out of place sa iyong mga kaibigan. And I believe God will also reconsider that. I believe if God will have to rewrite this verse, he would include cell phone. Amen?
Amen.
Not iPads. Not iPhone, just cell phone. Kasi pagka iPhone nights, medyo may kasama ng ano yun, may kasama ng kikapakikayan. Amen po? Bakit po sinabi ng Panginoon sa Panginoon, don't worry about the basic needs? Because God knows, Jesus knows, that when we start to worry about life, we will be robbed of the joy that life itself will bring. Tinan mo, look at your neighbor. Nawawalan siya ng ngiti. Nawalan ng smile sa labi. Kasi nga, yung mind is preoccupied with so many things that if you will only let go, you'll be able to see, wow, how blessed I am. Instead of focusing on things that in the first place, you have no power over them. Amen?
Amen.
Sino po dito ang may kakayanan pag naglagay ng buto sa lupa, when you put something, you plant something, who among of you has the power to let it grow? No? Wala. E bakit ka mag-worry? Now, worry and thinking are two different things. We can think about what we are going to eat, but don't worry about it. Amen? Because worry will take away your peace. Worry will take away your joy. Sa Tagalog, ang pangangamba, pag-aalala, labis-labis na pag-aalala sa mga bagay na ito ay nanakawin sa akin ang ating kaligayahan at ang ating kapayapaan. Amen?
Amen?
Let me give you some simple principles that we can find in those three verses. One, sinasabi po ng Diyos, because I am God, then I will feed. God feeds and God takes care of creation. So if God feeds and takes care of creation, are you one of this creation?
Yes.
You are. As a matter of fact, of all the creation that God created, we are His masterpiece. If we are His masterpiece, then if God looks at the rebel and takes good care of them, how much more will He do for us?
Yes. Yes.
Kung ito po may dalawang cellphone, para makakonek po sa mga kabataan, yung isa pong cellphone ay high-end, yung isa pong cellphone ay push button, may keypad. Saan doon ang naalagaan mo? Baka nga hindi mo nagamitin yung 3210, yung may antenna pa. Diba? Sino sa'yo yung 3110? 5110? Yung may antenna? Sino sa'yo yung meron pa ganun? Hindi nyo gagamitin yun. Ang naalagaan mo itong iPhone. Amen? Pero kung kukumpara po natin, yung pagpapahalaga, the value that God put between other creation and us, ang layo po. In creation alone, it was only during when God created humanity that He breathed. That alone speaks of our special relationship with God. That we are breathing the very breath of God in us. That alone signifies that, wow, this is how special I am with God. So why should I worry? Siyempre, isipin mo rin na sabi mo, yung pag-aalala at mag-isip, diba? Mag-isip ka rin na yung lulutuin ko mamaya ang tanghali, magpiprito ako, tapos magbubulay. Pag nag-aalala kasi ganito, ano kaya lulutuin ko? Saan kaya kukuha? Saan kaya kukuha? Tapos pagkatingan ka ng anak mo, ma, ano po? Wala na, yun na. Uminit ang ulo. God feeds and takes care of His creation. Sabi ko kanina, ano, hindi po tayo nandito ngayon para matuto, to educate. We are not here to educate ourselves. We are here to understand and live out God's principles. Because I strongly believe that most of us, or maybe all of us, already know the teachings of God. But the only problem is, how will I do it? How will I not worry when I am faced with such problem? How will I not worry when my when my parents are out of job, and I still need to finish my college. Parang ganun. Tama? How will I not worry when my GF, my girlfriend or my girlfriend, my boyfriend, seems not stop communicating with me? I let him go or let her go na. Bakit hindi siya forever mo? Ito po, kung titinan po natin, most of the time, we are worrying of things, about things that actually that we can live even without those things. Diba? Amen ba?
Yes.
Kaya nga po, hindi po tayo nandito para matuto. Because I believe we all know this. Even our parents have already told us, huwag ka mag-alala, don't worry. Sino po nasabihan ng mga nanay ng gano'n? Huwag ka mag-alala, anak. Ang sagot kita. Pero nag-aalala ka pa rin. Di ba? Yung mga magulang, yung mga older people, how many times have we been told by our friend or by somebody more influential or more older than us and telling us, don't worry, but still we keep on worrying? That only shows that every people knows about this principle, but we are not following this principle. Amen ba? Kaya nga po, sabi po ng Panginoon Jesus Cristo, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Kaya sinabi, don't worry about food, about your body, about your life. Don't worry. Because God knows you need that. Dapat ito po yung i-worry natin. The Word of God. Are we living in the Word of God? Pangalawa pong principle na makikita natin, worrying can never extend life. As a matter of fact, it shortens life. If you are filled with worry, ako, sa halip na pang 100 years ka, pang 70 years ka na lang, kasi inukuha mo, kinakain mo yung mga taong parating pa lang ngayon. Amen. So kung ito po ang katotohanan about worry, sabi po ng Panginoon Jesus sa Matthew 6, verse 20, so why do you worry about clothing? Hindi, kinakalala pag umina ko ng damit yung pensya. Yung signature. Bakit yung signature ba? Talaga may pirmado ba dito? Malalaman talaga? E disopin mo yung damit mo pabaliktad para nakikita yung itikita. Alright? You put on your clothes upside down so that people will be able to recognize, oh, it's branded. Because here, young people always want to buy those shirts with brand. When in fact, there are so many just to cover your body. That's the only purpose of clothing, just to cover your body, and somehow when you will go to a party, then you also are able to dress modestly. It has nothing to do with brands. Amen. Pero nakakalungkot, minsan natatawa ko kasi karamihan po ng mga young people, they go by brand. Di pa rin ang punit-punit na sa brand. Sa bagay, usunan niya yung punit-punit. Ano? So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field and how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Ano kayo kasunod? And yet I say to you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Hindi nga kinayanan ni King Solomon yun. Now, if God so clothes the grass of the fields, which today is, and tomorrow is thrown into fire, will He not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Don't worry. Amen ba? Pero para po sa mga young people, para hindi po kayo maubusan ng isusuot, maglaban-labanin kayo. Ay. Tama ba? Minsan kasi mga young people, this is what I have observed, only a very few young people knows how to wash their clothes. That's why when time comes that all of their clothes are already mabatok. Already in the labahan na, they will tell their parents, Ma, Pa, I have nothing to wear. Please buy me a new clothes. And then when their parents go to their room, oh, you have a bunch of clothes here. I'm all dirty. All you need to do is just to wash them and then you can wear them again. Amen? Ito po yung pinapakita natin is about worry. Ready na kayo? Worrying is for godless people. Why? Ask me why.
Why?
Because Jesus Christ taught the principle of worry-free life only to His disciples. And sabi niya, don't worry about life. Don't worry about your clothing. Because God, your Father, will take care of you. Don't even worry about the food that you will eat because God, your God, will provide for you. So when we start to worry, we are unknowingly we are drifting away from the principles of God. And if we are drifting away from the principles of God, we become like people who have no God. Amen? Worry is for godless people. Tell your neighbor that. That's why God is telling you not to worry because you are His child. Amen? And as a child of God, we must be worry-free. Tingin ko kung worry-free tayo, tingin ko pagdating pala natin dito, grabe na yung ngiti. Yung ambience, yung spirit that will hover in this place will be the spirit of joy. Why? Because I am free. Hindi ba yung pagpasok natin dito parang pasan-pasan mo ang buong daigdig? At greeted ka, no? You're greeted by the greeters outside. Good morning. You find it so difficult to put smile in your face. Why? Because you are thinking of so many things that in the first place, you have no power over them. Amen? You are worrying about your tomorrow when in fact you are living today. Don't bring tomorrow today. Much more, don't bring the past today. Live today because today is what God has given us. Amen? Pag ikaw po ay nabuhay bukas, ginagastos mo yung oras mo para bukas, so your life will be shortened. Pag ikaw ay nabuhay kahapon, namumuhay ka ngayon kahapon, kaya hindi ka rin makapag-move on. What God has given you, enjoy it. Thank God for it. Live today. Not yesterday, not tomorrow. Magkikita niyo tumangin. Ang iba po sa atin, advance. 2018 pa lang, gusto na 2019. Amen? Pero kung tikin na po natin ang buhay, nabubuhay pa doon sa 2017. Gusto niya 2019 na, pero nasa 2017 pa siya. Pero ang totoong katawan niya, nasa 2018, naghirap ano? That's why sometimes, if you will only look at the situation of people, especially Christians, there are so many Christians who are crazy. We want to live in the future, but our life speaks of our past, and we are living to this. It's crazy. Sometimes I can't understand people. You want the future to come, and yet you are making your decisions based on the past, not based on today. Therefore, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For after all, these things the Gentiles seek, the godless people, people who have no God, people who don't recognize God as their God, people who have no direct relationship with God, they worry about these things. So kung tayo pala nag-worry sa mga bagay na ito, anong pagkakaiba natin? Amen? For your Heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. Parang ganito po, mga Father. Diba? Tingin ko sa Pilipinas na ito applicable, not applicable to Western. Kaya tatagalugin ko. Di ba pag nakita po natin na yung aking lagayan ng bigas, wala na, anong gagawin mo? Ano po ang gagawin ng mga magulang? Ha? Siyempre, bibili. Bakit ka bibili? Wala na eh. Kasi alam mo, because you know that your children will ask for food, so you have to buy. Ngayon, tingnan po natin, ang aming Diyos, who is our Father, He knows what we need. And when He can see that we don't have the things that we need, will He not also provide? If even we are able to provide, sabi po ng Panginoon, if you, evil fathers, di ba yun ang description niya sa atin? Kayo nga, masasamang mga tatay, you can provide good things for your children. How much more your Heavenly Father will not provide for you? Hello? Your Heavenly Father knows that you need your food, you need food, you need clothing, you need shelter. God knows all of those things. Pero sabi niya, don't worry about those things because God is going to provide for you. Sino po gusto magkaroon ng worry-free life? Yung walang, so bigyan po kayo, nung sinabi po ng Panginoon sa Kristo, don't worry, that's the command. And then He gave two basic steps, which is also a command, so that we can have a free worry life. Ready na kayo?
Yes.
Ready na kayong i-apply ito?
Yes.
One, step to a free life. Free, worry-free life. Prioritize God's kingdom. Di ba we all know about this? Amen. We all know about this. See God's kingdom and His righteousness. And all these things will be added unto you. Oh boy. First step na kumantin ng Diyos. Prioritize God's kingdom. Our problem is to give God joy in the way we talk, we think, and live. It is God's problem to provide for us. Amen? Trabaho po ng Diyos yun. Yung tayo, of course, hindi ko po sinasabi, huwag kayo magtrabaho. We have to work. But it is God's problem to provide for us. Our problem and our obligation, our role, is to prioritize His kingdom. Because we are His children. Amen?
Amen.
The role of the Father is to provide. And our role is to obey. To prioritize His kingdom.
Minsan binabalik kasi natin yun. Hindi, ako ang magpo-provide sa sarili ko. Ako ang magpapalaki ng puno ng mangga. Ako ang magpapabunga. Hindi mo nga kaya yun eh. Sabi ng Diyos, you prioritize me and my righteousness and I will take care of you. If you take care of yourself, if you don't prioritize God and His righteousness, we are already acting as if we are God. Hindi ko po sinasabi, I'm not saying you should not work. We should work. And I believe children of God must be the smartest and hardest worker on planet Earth. Yes. Ask me why. Ask me why. Because our God is the smartest and hardest worker in the whole universe. Amen? Kaya sabi niya ng Jesus Christ said, I must work because my Father is working even to this day. We must work, but we must not worry about life. Amen? Amen? Because God will provide. Amen ba? Ano ang role natin?
Obey.
Ano ang priority natin? God's kingdom and His righteousness. Amen? The problem is, when we are faced with challenge, this is the very first thing that we put aside. God, I have problems, so I will put you will be my second priority now. I will focus on solving my problem. Tama ba? Ano naging resulta? Sa halip, instead of our problem, instead of finding solution to our problem now gets another problem. Nanganak ng problema, hanggang sa tayo, palayo na ng palayo sa ating Diyos. Now our worries are being compounded. Worries. Because the step, the formula, the solution that God provides for us so that we will have a worry-free life is very simple. Prioritize me and my righteousness. My kingdom and my righteousness. Amen? Pagdating ng linggo, hindi, sayang. Sayang naman. Kikita pa ako. Nakakalimutan, kinatalikuran po natin ng Diyos. Pero gusto natin, wala tayong mga alalahanin. Diba? Amen ba? Pag-aaral. Ano hirap talaga ako makaintindi sa aming subject. May pangako po ang Diyos dyan, God had a promise. Ang sabi po ng Panginoon, wisdom begins with the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord in the New Testament is seek first God's kingdom and His righteousness. That's the fear of the Lord. You find it difficult to understand your lessons in school, then seek the Lord and seek God and His righteousness. I tell you, this really works. When I was at your age, my young people, when I was at your age, though during those times, I have never heard messages like this, but I believe in that verse, wisdom begins with the fear of the Lord. No one told me how to fear God, so I figured it out on my own. And I believe how I figured it out, God impressed me on how to figure out the fear of the Lord is. I'm telling you, it will not be difficult for you to understand your lessons in school if you seek God and His righteousness. Amen. Trabaho nyo, your work, you have so many deadlines in your work. Seek God and His righteousness. And if you are seriously serious about seeking God, prioritizing God's kingdom, hindi po pwedeng hindi pagkaloob ng Diyos sa kanyang anak. God will never withhold from His child the things that His child needs.
Amen?
Amen. He is a very loving Father. He will not withhold. But seek first God's kingdom. The kingdom of God and His righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. Prioritize God's kingdom. Amen?
Amen.
Amen ba?
Amen.
Gusto mo sa trabaho, you want to be promoted? Prioritize God's kingdom. Pangalawa po, do not fast forward life's concern. Neither don't go backward. Huh? Don't fast forward. Kung ano po yung concern mo ngayon, ngayon lang, huwag mong i-concern yung bukas. Don't be so concerned about tomorrow. Because today has its own problem. You don't even know what will happen tomorrow. What God has given you is today. So make the most out of today, not for tomorrow. Amen? Do not extend to this grace for tomorrow. Because God's grace is new every morning. Tomorrow, God's grace will be upon you. I'm very sure of that.
Yes.
But whatever grace that God has given us today, make the most out of it. It's the only thing that God has given us today. Thank God for it. Amen?
Amen,
amen ba?
Amen.
Kung mayroon po kayo ang grasya ng Diyos sa'yo, pasalamatan mo kayo. O kung isipin yung bukas, malay mo bukas deep state. Tuyo na nga ngayon, mag-alala ka pa bukas. Eh, lalo naging tuyo yung ngayon. Do not extend today's grace for tomorrow. When the nation of Israel was in the wilderness, God commanded them, okay, every day, go out, every morning, go out and pick manna, bread. Meron po mga tao na talagang sadyang kahangan. Yung ano bang kahangan sa Tagalog sa English?
Greedy.
So they gather manna for 2 days. Ano po nangyari? Yung manna po naging mabantot. Manna symbolizes the grace of God. They are new every morning. God will... Don't worry, God will not forget. God will not forget to let that grace, His grace, flow through us and in us every morning.
Amen.
Because that is who our God is. That is who our Father is. He will make sure that every day, each one of us will receive the grace we need.
Amen.
Yes. Amen? Huwag kang mag-imbak ng grasya para bukas. Kasi bukas yung grasya ngayon panis na. Alright? Do not extend to this grace for tomorrow. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow. For tomorrow will worry about its own thing. Sufficient for the day is its own problem. What God has given today, praise God. Lord, thank you for this grace. Nagkaroon ko ba kayo? No? Every time you wake up, are you still able to say, Lord, thank you, I'm still alive. That's the first grace that God is giving us. You are able to wake up every morning.
Why would you like to wake up and then when you wake up, you realize you're already dead? So when you wake up, you say, oh Lord, my body is complete. Thank you. You have given me another life. Amen?
Amen.
O baka naging natural na lang, masyado nang naging ano na lang sa atin, taken for granted na natural na lang pag natulog, magigising talaga ako kinabukasan. No, it's not that. It's the grace of God. It's not natural. It's supernatural. Because you could have died last night. And mind you, if you wake up this morning, if some people wake up this morning and found out that they're already dead, God will always be holy. Amen. Amen ba?
Amen.
Lord, thank you that I'm alive today. I will not worry about tomorrow because your grace is sufficient for me today. Amen.
Amen.
I will worry tomorrow when I am already in my tomorrow. If we keep on worrying, we will be fearful. Hindi niyo po ba alam, don't you know that worry is one of the powerful tool that Satan is instigating in our mind and in our heart? Because if we keep on worrying, we will be fearful and won't be able to do God's mandate to us. Because we are so preoccupied with so many things, and in the very thing that God tells us to do, we will forget it because we have so many concerns. Amen? Huwag po tayong magpahuli sa taktika ng kalaban. Worry, fear, intimidation, ito po yung mga taktika ng demonyo na kapag tayo ay nasilo niya, kung hirap makawala. Do what is best today and give the rest to God. Amen? Amen ba, children of God?
Amen.
Siguro po sa atin, wala po siguro itong gusto maging failure. Sino po dito ang gusto maging successful sa buhay? We all want to be successful. And I would like to close here. Ano nga bang failure? Failure is unable to accomplish the works that God willed to be accomplished in our life. At paano po tayo nagiging failure? Nagiging failure po tayo pagka tayo po ay maraming mga alalahaning iniisip. Kasi sa halip na tayo po ay mag-focus sa ating Panginoon sa Kristo, kung ano-anong ating iniisip, at yung isang bagay na gusto kong ipagawa sa atin ng Diyos, yung maraming hindi ginagawa. Amen? And I pray, that none of us, even our young people, I pray to God that none of us will fail.
Yes.
Because when Jesus Christ will come and we will all stand definitely before God. He will not ask us about many things. He will only ask us one thing. What have you done to the life of giving? Ano yung life na yun? Real life, eternal life. Nakalimutan ko po kasi masyado akong naging abala. Ang dami kong alalahanin. Hindi ko po nagawa, pinapagawa ninyo. Tapos na. Ano po ang mga bagay na sa tingin ninyo dapat yung ginagawa as the manifestation of you, of us prioritizing God's kingdom? Things that we should have done, and until today we are still thinking, should I do it? Or should I just let it go? Brothers and sisters, I believe we only have a very short time. Amen? We have a very short time to live. We have known God, we have accepted God, and most assuredly, all of us love God. But if we fill our life with worries, we'll never be able to do what God wanted us to do. We'll never be able to accomplish what God wanted us to accomplish in our life. I am beseeching you in the name of God. Live for today. Thank God for His grace every day. If there are failures, let it go. If there are dreams that you are not able to reach, let it go. Focus. What God has given you today. And what is it that God has given you today? Your life, your mind. Amen? And if there are still things that you know within yourself you would have done for God, and you are just so fearful of fear and you did not even start doing it, why not start? God will not be joyful over us if we keep on being lukewarm in our love for Him. God wants a love that is passionate. Amen? Because when He loves us, and every time He shows His love to us, it is always given passionately. Diba, hindi po nag-aalaman ng Diyos pag minahal niya tayo. That's why He died on the cross. Because He was very passionate. Ano po yung mga worries ninyo? Meron ba kayong worries? O meron po kayong worries sa kung kayo maya sa katabi nyo, just stand up. And we will pray together. So if you have worries in life, worries about relationship, worries about business, worries about your study, just stand and let us pray to God. God wants you to live your life free of worries. I want you to pray to God right now. Just talk to God. Lord, I have this fear. Lord, I have this worry. Come on, just talk to God. Father, your children, Father God, are here. Acknowledging, Father God, that they have also worries in their lives. God has commanded us that we should not worry, even for our very own life. And worrying for things, relationships, business, or whatever things, O God. Father, is a direct disobedience to your command. I ask, O God, and I pray, Father God, for your mercy. Would you allow the holy blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, to just wash and forgive each one of us? Because we have not lived out this principle that you have taught us. And I pray, Father, would you reach out to your people? Would you touch them? Would you help them feel that you are God, that you are their Father? And oh Lord, you only want He cares for us. And Lord, we'll not be able to see the best things, the good things that you have in store for us if our mind, O God, is preoccupied with so many worries. In the name of Jesus, I ask you, my brother, believe, trust that. If you are worried about your future, believe and trust God that your future is already secured in His hand. You have a good future, and the future belongs to you. If you have a worry about a relationship, give it to God. Let God restore such relationship. You're worried about your family. Filled with worries. Father, we thank you.